What happens during Mohs surgery? During Mohs surgery, usually a biopsy will have been performed before the Mohs surgery is to be performed on the day of surgery. That biopsy result may be either a basal cell, a squamous cell carcinoma, or even a melanoma. On the day of Mohs surgery, the biopsy is confirmed by the Mohs surgeon. The area is photographed, and then that area is numbed by an assistant or the Mohs surgeon. And after the area is numbed, a thin layer of skin is obtained around the area of the skin cancer. That tissue is then mapped and cut to create microscopic slides. This process takes about an hour to complete. After the microscopic slides are created, the Mohs surgeon takes a look at the microscopic slides, and based on a map that he's created, will mark whether A, there's any skin cancer left, or B, if there's no skin cancer left, then that case is completed, and the physician will go back, speak to the patient, and consider what reconstructive options are to be performed. The important factor in what happens during Mohs surgery is the person doing the surgery is the person reading the pathology, meaning that has to be one and the same physician. It can't be that the Mohs surgeon removes the skin cancer and has someone else look at the microscopic slides. Both of those functions must be completed by the same individual, and therein lies the training. The training of a Mohs surgeon in a fellowship-trained program involves an extensive and very intensive process whereby you perform both those duties on hundreds, if not thousands, of patients, leading you to a position where you can perform that procedure comfortably and with the knowledge base that's required for you to get great results.